Hello friends, today I am going to show you how to bypass FRP lock in Samsung devices using combination firmware. So this is Galaxy S8 Plus and this solution is also working in S8, S9, S9 Plus, Note 8, Note 9 and all Samsung devices which have Android 7.0.1 and 8.0.0. So you can see here this device is asking Gmail account. If you want to unlock your device, then keep watching this video till the end. Before starting the solution, please subscribe my channel, press subscribe button, also press bell icon to get my latest videos notification. So let's start the solution. From here we have turned the device off because we want to check the binary version. Press volume up key, Bixby key and power key. Press three keys combination for 5 seconds. Now release the key when you see the Samsung logo, Galaxy logo. Now keep pressing volume up and Bixby key. We want to boot our device into recovery mode because we want to check the factory binary version to download perfect combination firmware. Now installing system update. Press power key and volume up key. We have to wait for 6 or 7 seconds more. This is the easy solution to check the binary version. Now you can see here, this is G55FXXU4 is the binary version. So we have to download the same firmware. First of all, put your device in the download mode. Press Bixby, volume down and power key for 10 seconds. Now press volume up key to continue. Now we can connect our device later. So first of all, let me download the combination firmware. So my device model number is G55F and I am going to download combination firmware. Just search it. You can get the official website. This is official website for combination firmware. Click on this link. Now website has opened. Now we have to search here U4 G55F. This is G5550 and G55F. This is G55F and here we have to check U4. So this is my perfect version for combination firmware for my device. Just click on this link. Now you have to verify that you are downloading a perfect file which is matching your Android version. Click on download button. Enter your email address or first name and last name. Just download button. Here you can get the download link. Click on this link. Actually I have already downloading this file, so I am just showing you that how to download combination from here for Galaxy S8 Plus. Now I am going to download Odin, Samsung Odin. Search on Samsung Odin Pango because we want to download the latest version. Just open this link and here you can get the latest version of Odin tool. Do not use other Odin because you required a latest Odin version, otherwise you will not be able to flash the combination from here. So this is the Odin 3.13. just click on this link. You can see here Odin has been downloaded. Now extract here. Close this and I am going to extract my combination firmware. It takes time, that's why I have fast forward this clip. It has taken around 5 minutes. So this is my combination firmware, you can see here. And this is Odin. Just first of all you will have to connect the Samsung device, you can see here. So connect the type C cable. Now my device has been connected. Now I can open the Odin. This is very important that you will have to connect the device first and then open the Odin. Now select I have to select combination firmware in FP field. I have to select AP, not bootloader. Select AP and in desktop, Hatchet Plus. This is my combination firmware. Click on open. It takes around 2 or 3 minutes. That's why I have fast forward. Now my device has been connected and device combination has been loaded. Click on start button. Click start button. I have fast forward this clip also because it has taken around 10 to 12 minutes. Do not disconnect your device while your device is flashing. You can see here combination has been flashed. My device will reboot 3 or 2 times. Now I have fast forwarded this clip also. Now you can see here combination menu. So this is a service menu. Open settings and click on about. Here you will have to enable the developer option. Multiple click on build number. Open developer menu and here enable the USB debugging. And if you have found here OEM unlocking, then you will have to enable it also. Now I am going to enable ADB. In case my combination will not work, then I will use ADB to unlock my device. Turn the device off. You can remove the USB cable and press Bixby volume down and power key to put the device into download mode. Press volume up key to continue. Connect the USB type C cable again because I want to flash the stock firmware. First of all, let me download the stock firmware. Samsung firmware, space firmware, Pangu. I have to download the same firmware U4 version. So this is Asset Plus and G55F version. So you can get the firmware from here, G55U4. You can see here, just copy this link and paste it into the URL. Hit enter. Click on download button. Actually, I have already downloaded this file also to save time. Close it and extract the firmware file. This is our stock firmware. I have fast forward this clip also. This is four file folder. So just open the Odin. You can see here, this is 4 files and open Odin. You can see here my device has been connected. Select bootloader in BL. Select BL. Click open. Now select AP field. AP. It takes time, that's why I have fast forward it. Do not select CP file, just select CSC. You must select your home file in CSC field. Let me install it. Now my device has been connected and all files are loaded here. Click on start button. The flashing has been started. This clip is also fast forward, otherwise the video will go longer, so that's why I have fast forward this also. Do not disconnect your device while flashing is going on. You can see here my device has been flashed. So let me install it and it takes around 5 to 8 minutes to boot my device properly. Now you can see here my device has been on and the language has changed because I have chosen wrong firmware. This is not my country firmware. You can see here my device has been unlocked. And if you like this video, please hit the like button. Also share this video on your friends. You can check here Android version. I think I have to change the language first. This is you can see here 8.0.0. And thank you for watching this video. See you in next video. Till then, bye.